Now, I will give this message the way I received it, in the first person. So that's the way that it will be delivered to you today. State of the Church Address, 2024. The commander of the host of the Lord says to his church, Deuteronomy, know therefore that the Lord your God, He is God, the faithful God, who keeps His covenant and His loving kindness to a thousandth generation with those who love Him and keep His commandments. This is an eternal promise, an irrevocable agreement, sealed with my blood and ratified in the throne room. I will never leave you nor forsake you. Though the nations rage and politicians devise wicked plans, though the mighty fall and the knees of the strong buckle, you need not fear nor be troubled, for I am your Lord, your Redeemer, and your Savior. I never sleep. My care over you is 24/7, because I am your faithful Lord. I was there when you were conceived. I was there when you were born. I was with you when you were afraid, and I rejoiced when you laughed with delight. I've been with you every day of your life, and great was my joy when you welcomed me into your heart. And be utterly assured, I came to stay. I'm not a visitor, I'm a resident. I've made myself at home in your spirit, never to depart. I say to you at this time what I said to my disciples long ago. Do not fear, little flock, for it's your Father's good pleasure to give you the kingdom. And what a magnificent kingdom it is. Truly did the apostle exclaim, eye has not seen, nor ear heard, nor has it entered into the heart of man the things which God has prepared for those who love Him. This year of 2024 that you have entered will be marked by wars on several fronts. You have entered a season of war, and therefore it will be a very sobering year, a very tumultuous year. Conflicts will rage, and divisions of peoples will increase. The area of the Middle East will become more and more dangerous as nations and people throw off constraints and vent their frustrations and their anger. People groups will set themselves against each other, and the enemy will try desperately to stoke the fires of racism and secularism, but he will utterly fail as you, my church, stand firm on my word and my grace, refusing to entertain his agenda for even 1 minute. Amen. More than a few times, you will hear a sound from the spirit realm declaring, blow the trumpet in Zion and sound an alarm in my holy mountain. Let all the inhabitants of the land tremble, for the day of the Lord is coming, for it is at hand. Those who listen to my voice will hear it, and my spirit will tell you how to pray in that hour. Hear me clearly, beloved disciples. This year has a certain uniqueness, making it unlike any other year. You will see things in 2024 that you never thought you'd see. And you will hear things you never thought that you would hear. Brace yourself and understand that these things must happen, for you are in the very end of days. During 2023, many things were secretly set in motion by governments and agencies that will soon emerge in the form of decisions and policies designed to utterly remake this nation into a godless society. Change will be a major word and a major activity in 2024. Political leaders will press hard against the America you have known in the past, and they will seek to transform and even eliminate traditional values and principles previously held sacred. My grace will be with you as you stand for righteousness. Prepare yourselves to stand. Some who've been considered giants will fall. Some will be taken away in order to escape a fall. And the humble in spirit will be lifted up. Those who are the hidden jewels in my body will shake my church. And many will ask and wonder, where did they come from? Who are these who speak like the Almighty? Where did they get such understanding? For I will use the unknowns, the simple and the humble, in this year to confront the wise and the proud. Know this, a spirit of deception has invaded this nation and even invaded some in my body. That spirit has deployed demonic troops to harass, to intimidate, to destabilize, and destroy the warriors of the living God. It shall not succeed. Amen. If you stand firm in my word. Amen. Deception has infiltrated your government, your education system, your judicial system, the entertainment industry, and the media. The enemy has torn down the gates of moral values and barged his way into what was once a God-fearing nation. The destruction of boundaries has been a large part of his agenda, not just in your nation, but even within my church. Boundaries are for protection, but this present generation despises boundaries. In doing so, they prepare only disaster for themselves. I caution you, my disciples, to respect my boundaries, for they are a gift from me to you for your very good. My word is your boundary. Immerse yourself in my word. Read it. Meditate on it, live by it, and you will never have to fear. For my word is the lamp to guide your way, and is the lamp on the highway of your life. So, my beloved, take heed to my warning and arm yourselves, for this is not a year to entertain distractions or follow after empty pursuits. This is not a year for self-gratification or satisfaction and frivolous luxuries. I say it again, this is a serious year.